I'm scrolling through Instagram and one of my favorite designers posted a picture of herself in a sweatshirt she designed. The caption read, "The best sweatshirt ever. I'm still so grateful we were able to do this collaboration with at Terry O'Neill Official and his team." The picture is an iconic photo of Brigitte Bardot, shot by Terry O'Neill. I then scroll to her specific Instagram handle, to which I see what looks like an original signed print of the same photo hanging up in her house. The same photo with two very different meanings and very different price tags. The image originated by the photographer named Terry O'Neill. Terry was a famous photographer that captured youth culture over a range of industries, including movies, fashion, music, starting his career in the early 1960s and has recently passed in 2019. He photographed icons from Winston Churchill to Nelson Mandela, Elvis, Audrey Hepburn, Nicole Kidman, The Beatles, and Elton John, but the list goes on and on. Brigitte Bardot was a French film actress. The photo was captured on a movie set of the movie The Legend of Frenchie King in Spain in the year 1971. It was the last frame on the roll of film. He said, "I only had one crack at it, and it turned out to be a stunner. The wind blew and I took the picture." There's only 50 original copies of the photo in a variety of sizes that were signed and numbered by the creator himself, Terry O'Neill. The photograph represented femininity and iconicity. Anine Bing was not the first to mechanically reproduce this image and will certainly not be the last. Her sweatshirt that she created lacks one important thing that the original photo hanging in her house does, and that is the here and now. Walter Benjamin describes this idea in his book, The Work of Art in the Age of Its Technological Reproducibility. He says, "In even the most perfect reproduction, one thing is lacking, the here and now of the work of art. Its unique existence in a particular place. It is the unique existence and nothing else that bears the mark of history to which the work has been the subject." Their collaboration to create the sweatshirt was actually Terry O'Neill's idea. In a Vogue interview, she described his work as so effortlessly rock and roll, so timeless, it's iconic. Nobody else shoots pictures like that anymore. Terry read a different article in which Anine had spoke so highly of him, and he reached out to build something together with her. They had been working on this project for a whole year, and then just 3 days before the launch, he unfortunately passed away. The history of the original image is changing, constantly shifting. As Walter adds, "This history includes changes to the physical structure of the work over time. Together with any changes is ownership." As you can observe, Anine Bing's name is added to the bottom left-hand corner of the photograph, and Terry's is now on the right-hand side. This made me think, who really owns the image now? Is it Anine, Terry, or maybe both of them together? Because one would not exist without the other. The original image was taken in 1971, and then 46 years later, it was changed to add two signatures on the bottom left and right corners, then screen printed onto many sweatshirts and many t-shirts to be sold to customers. The photo now lives in so many different places. It lives on Anine Bing's website and on Google in hundreds of closets around the world. And when they are worn outside with the t-shirts or the sweatshirts, the image lives on the streets, in the coffee shops, and talking to old friends. Then when you take a picture of yourself in the sweatshirt you're wearing, it's now seen on social media through applications like Instagram and Facebook. It also lives in print fashion magazine spreads and advertisements. All of these places the image has lived and traveled to are places where the original photo taken in 1971 could have never been. I believe Walter Benjamin says it best that, quote, "The technical reproduction can place the copy of the original in situations which the original itself cannot attain." While the photograph has transitioned slightly through reproduction, the integrity of the image has still not been altered. It still represents femininity and iconicity. Walter continues to explain this idea of art in photography in The Little History of Photography, stating that, but the emphasis changes completely if we turn from photography as art to art as photography. Everyone will have noticed how much easier it is to get a hold of a painting, more particularly a sculpture, and especially architecture, in a photograph than in reality. As we turn more towards art as photography, it is hard not to bring up the point of access, and specifically how much it costs to access these works of art. An original piece of Brigitte Bardot ranges from $7,000 to $70,000, depending on the size, while a sweatshirt or t-shirt from Anine Bing with a similar photo costs from a range of $100 to $150. While even cheaper, a print on Etsy ranges from $20 to $60. It is so much easier to access these photos through technological reproduction than experience it in reality.